Phuket Extra is brought to you by Coast Beach Club and Bistro at Centara Grand Beach Resort. Chill in the sun, sip under the stars.
Sawadee krap and welcome to Phuket Extra, brought to you by Coast Beach Club and Bistro at Centara Grand Beach Resort Phuket. I'm JP Mistanza, and here's the news you need to know. An arrest has been made in the murder of a Patong tuk-tuk boss, Sakol Srisompoch, as police say they have nabbed the man who drove the motorbike that was used in the street slaying in Katu late last month. The 28-year-old suspect, who police declined to name, was taken into custody back on Friday in the northern province of Mai Hong Song, where he went to get married. Police allege that he's an accomplice in the death of 58-year-old Sakol, who was shot dead on October 25th in Katu, in what police say has been a dispute over the territory of tuk-tuk clubs in Patong and other areas. Also in custody is the victim's rival, Watana Dam Nawakeo, who is the head of a competing tuk-tuk taxi service group, and he's facing charges of conspiracy to murder. For more on this story, visit thephuketnews.com. And police are scratching their heads and trying to identify the rotting corpse of a man who was found in the waters of Rasada Pier on Sunday. Local authorities believe the man had been dead for 15 days before his body was found, though it's unclear if he was murdered. For more on this, visit thephuketnews.com. And the results of the latest Phuket News poll are in, and it looks like local tourists and expats are split over having Phuket beaches return to, quote, virgin status, which would abolish vendors on the sands. In the last month, new Phuket Governor Chokchai Dechamortan announced that he would take steps to clear all Phuket beaches of all vendors. Currently, Phuket beaches have 10% zones where vendors can work at selected areas and hand-picked beaches. But our two-week poll shows 14% agreed with the governor to clear the beaches of all vendors, while 31% also agreed to get rid of vendors, though they did want tourists to be allowed to bring sun loungers. Meanwhile, a whopping 41% said officials should allow vendors on all Phuket beaches. For more on this, visit thephuketnews.com. And stay right there. Phuket Extra will be right back after this.
Hola, Carioca's Bistro and Lounge. Open daily, except Tuesdays, from 7 a.m. till midnight. Facebook Carioca's Lounge.
Welcome back to Phuket Extra. The story of the Israeli man who is thought to have killed his compatriot last week and tried to hide it by placing the dismembered body in a wall. Well, it looks like there's way more to his story than originally thought. Thai authorities are now looking into the disappearance of a murder suspect Shimon Batal's Thai wife, Nantia Saungurai, who had not been seen for over a year. The pair have a 17-year-old son who is accused of helping his father dispose of the body last week. In their investigation, it's already come out that Batal is an ex-convict who spent 10 years in prison in another separate murder case. Batal and his son are already being investigated for last week's murder of 63-year-old Eliyahu Cohen, who is a former Israeli police officer and a convicted murderer himself who spent 8 years in Thai prison for killing his wife. The investigation is certainly ongoing. And officials fear the worst after a witness to the disappearance of an Australian motorcycle gang leader last year has gone missing himself just days before the court verdict in the case is set to be announced. The witness is a security guard at a Pattaya housing estate who was there the night 37-year-old Wayne Schneider was abducted. Schneider's body was found 2 days later in a shallow roadside grave just 30 kilometers away from Pattaya. His former bodyguard and business associate, Antonio Bagnaro, was later arrested for allegedly leading the whole thing. A verdict is expected Thursday in Pattaya. Man, finally, thousands of Phuket residents came out for the traditional Loy Krathong festival in a subdued fashion with no fireworks as a sign of respect to honor His Majesty the late King Bhumibol Adulyadej. The peaceful night saw no live entertainment, which usually marks the festivities. Friends and families around the island came out to float small decorated baskets into the sea in a sign of letting the negativity of the past simply leave. And that's it for all of us at Phuket Extra today. Thank you for joining us. From all of us here at Phuket Extra, we're looking forward to seeing you again tomorrow. Until then, stay classy, Phuket.